In the last tutorial, I demonstrated how to create a custom menu in WordPress, and that menu appears here in the top primary menu position in the theme that we're using. In this tutorial, I want to demonstrate how to create a sub-menu item and illustrate how the parent-child relationships work in WordPress. First, let's go back to the dashboard and select Menus from the Appearance flyout. To get started, we want to create a ghost menu item or a menu item that really doesn't link to anything at all. And we're going to use this links feature here to do that. Now, we can use this feature to add in an external URL if we'd like, but we're going to replace this HTTP prefix with a pound sign. We'll also add in link text, and this is the way the text appears for this menu item on the front end of the WordPress site. Once we've added in that link text, I'll click on the Add to Menu button and notice how that menu item has been added to the menu structure. Next, we'll click on the Save Menu button to save the menu, and once it's saved, we'll return to the front end of the WordPress site and we'll refresh the page. Notice how the Browser Inventory menu item appears in our main menu, but I'm clicking on it and it doesn't go anywhere. That's because we added in the pound sign instead of an external link. Let's return to the dashboard now to create a new page that we can have as a child page of that menu item. I'll first add in a title, of course, and then I want to go to a Microsoft Word document that I created, and I'm going to copy that text. Remember, when I copy that text out of a Word document and I want to erase any formatting that goes into the WordPress site, I'll click on this Paste as Text feature within the editor. To liven up this page a little bit, I also want to embed an image, so I'll put my cursor here and click on the Add Media button to select an image I've already uploaded to the WordPress site. I demonstrated how to do this in more detail in tutorial number 8 of this series. Remember that you can always select a parent for any page that you create, but that doesn't automatically mean that that page will be a sub-menu item. Let's go ahead and publish this page so we can create a new page by clicking on the Add New button here. We'll follow the same process as before by adding in a title, and both pages we're creating will be sub-menu items of the Browser Inventory menu item that we created. I'll again go back to the Microsoft Word document and copy the text that I've created for this page. I'll return to the dashboard and I'll paste this in as plain text. Once I've pasted that text in, I'll do the same thing as I did before by putting my cursor here and clicking on the Add Media button and selecting an image that I've uploaded to my WordPress site so I can embed that image into the page. Next, I'll click on the Publish button. Both of the pages I just created are now available on the front end of the WordPress site. If I return to the front end and refresh the page, I'll see that I can access the acoustic guitars and electric guitars pages here. However, I don't want these pages to appear in the top primary menu as a top level menu item. So I'll return to the dashboard and I'm going to select the menus item from the appearance flyout. We'll see all 5 of these pages in our menu structure, and all I need to do is simply drag and drop each of the pages I just created so that they are indented below Browser Inventory. Once I save the menu, I can return to the front end of the WordPress site and I'll refresh the page so I can see the changes. Notice how the 2 additional pages are now removed and they reappear as sub-menu items or drop-down menu items below Browser Inventory. Both of these menu items are now considered drop-down or sub-menu items. In the next tutorial, I'll demonstrate how to use WordPress widgets and widget-ready areas.